not bad.
Hi, darling.
There he is.
Hi.
How are you?
You got seven.
Yeah, I did. You got in last night, too?
Yes.
It's the first day of rehearsals for another season in the Avon Theater. This one promises to be busier than ever with revivals of both the Mikado and the Gondoliers, and a new production, Iolanthe, a wacky fairy tale. Maureen Forrester will play the Fairy Queen.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Eric Donkin, the Lord Chancellor.
You're welcome.
Madam Chairman.
Oh, not today. Not today.
For me, Brian McDonald, first rehearsals are like those initial encounters which lead to first love, filled with energy, enthusiasm, and lots of anxiety.
I never like to come into anything with the problem, first of all. I like to come in with the solution. But the show has some problems in it, in that its topicality at that time is not the same today at all. Fairies have an entirely different connotation to what they had in Gilbert's time, and we just have to face up with that and live with it. A character who's a fairy from the waist up, but thank God not from the waist down. And I've asked various people, other directors in New York, how audiences today reacted to that, and they said that it goes right over the heads of the older audience members, and that young people fall about the floor at those references.
Around your waist.
Ah!
Okay.
Oh, can we play? I've never been winged before.
And then from some.
Iolanthe was first performed over 100 years ago. It tells of forbidden romances between fairies and mortals, and it's laced with allusions to the politics and proprieties of Victorian England.
I'm a floppy fairy.
It's like training bras.
That's why mine doesn't fit.
I wouldn't know. I never wore one.
That's
why
mine doesn't.
You're funny. You're the lost fairy.
You're the lost.
I am the way I
do.
You were
fairy.
Upside down.
Jump in the world, nothing very much happened. We may release your arm, right? We may take it away somehow and sneak it down here and go right down, terribly swan-like, right down into that, right? And as you come up, bring this leg through to here. Come up in your knee, bring that leg through, and then turn, right, and sit on the ground here. One of these. So, and if they don't connect terribly well, don't worry about that. So from here, keep this fairly far. If it gets far out, you've had it. You have to kind of keep it under you, and this is again floating in the air there. 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 That. You've come from here, and you do this wonderful arabesque. You have to be with her, and then there's a moment when you're going to step over her leg, and you can really get that. You know, yo, yeah, just, I've got to get over that leg. Make it all happen. We're not looking for a laugh. We're looking for sort of a chuckle and fun, and we want to like them all very much at the beginning. Yeah, I do it on the one. 5, 6, 7, 8, yeah. Yeah, all right. Make sense, Karen? Yeah? I tell you, you have to be terribly ready. Kelly and Anne will help you with all this stuff after, but you have to be terribly ready here to, when you get to whatever foot you're doing that plie on, plie and go. But don't find yourself stuck back here because you go plie and it's no help. You're not getting anywhere. You've got to be ready to go on that foot. Can I just see that again? Okay. Little under tempo. Now this, ladies, is it's like it's got to be your best step and you worked for hours And so you're really kind of showing it all off, and the head can climb from one side to the other. It's called affectation. You've only got to go to France, and you can see it right till this day. So, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1. Right, you can be quite close together, you two. That's it. And heads inclined away. Oh, no, towards each other.
My legs want to be there.
Now that's...
This production actually took shape when I was driving between Montreal and Toronto with Susan Benson, my designer and close collaborator. We decided to do what a turn-of-the-century operatic troupe might have done, with our sets in traveling crates that open, like pop-up pictures in books of children's fairy tales.
And this is all workable, danceable on.
Yes. Now, it's just what we're talking about before, though you're a bit tight coming in there.
Yeah.
All right, but there's not much you can do about that.
Do little things up here, yes. Too.
It's, I mean, the other thing is to straighten really. Out just a bit more.
Yeah, we can play with that as we put people on stage. You know.
That's wonderful.
Good.
It's lovely.
Thank good.
Not quite as much nope. There.
Yeah, that's fine. So that also yes. Gives us a little entrance around yes. The corner coming in there, yes. Which is fine.
And it's lovely because we put through the trees. And mm.
You're so far so. Ahead already. You have all this ready. Ingenuity. Marvelous.
The props people at Stratford are absolutely world-class. You can ask for almost anything, and someone will go quietly out and make it, and then make it work in a special way. The men in the show are peers of the realm, complete with crowns and capes.
5, 6, 7, hand up. Starting on the word law, first of all, that'll help. And I, my lords, embody the law. Boom, boom, boom. Ba-ya-ba-ba-ba. Just be here. Just start. Yeah, okay. Go.
Though the compliment implied inflates me with incredible pride, it nevertheless can't be denied that it has its inconvenient side. but I'm not so old and I'm not so plain, and I'm quite prepared to marry again. But there be the deuce to pay in the lords if I fell in love with one of my lord wards. Chancellor who is in love with a ward of his own court are not to be envied.
No.
What is his position?
Well,
can he give his own consent to his own marriage with his own ward?
Okay.
Can he marry his own ward without his own consent? And if he marry his own ward without his own consent, can he commit himself to his own court? And yes? For contempt of his own court? And if he commit himself to contempt of his own court, can he appear by counsel before himself to order the arrest of his own judgment? Ah, my lords, the feelings, it is indeed painful to sit on the horns of such a dilemma.
During the Stratford season, the costume department will provide more than 600 costumes for 13 separate productions, making it roughly equivalent to a small garment factory, but one which specializes in high fashion.
Now, the McAdams costume.
Yes. This was all painted in sections, starting out with just plain pieces of white silk, and they again were stretched on a frame to make the painting easier. So the fabric is taut, and each segment is drawn out with a resist and painted in a similar way to the way the wings were painted. This is a pongee, and this was a sample starting out, figuring out how to do pishtushes, kimono. Yum Yum had a green one, which was her wedding kimono, with the willow leaves down it. And then she had the pink one, which had quite an intricate design all over.
Benson's Mikado costumes made an unexpected appearance on the international stage when the company was invited to perform in London. The occasion was a gala performance at the Old Vic, hallmark of British theatrical tradition, purchased and refurbished with style and elegance by Toronto businessman Ed Mervish. Many of the sights and sounds of today's London existed during Victoria's reign. Opera and theater flourished, and writer W.S. Gilbert and his partner composer Arthur Sullivan combined their talents to create 14 enormously popular comic operas, which gently satirized many aspects of British society. The old Vic's original interior was probably never this elegant. For one thing, the carpets wouldn't stand up to the beer-swilling theater-goers of the Industrial Revolution.
Hairdressers are samurais.
The demise of the Doyley Cart Opera Company, England no longer has an operatic troupe specializing in Gilbert and Sullivan. And while I've largely ignored the detailed stage instructions provided by Gilbert, we've tried to prove ourselves worthy successors to a famous tradition. When the royalty on stage finished their bows, we trooped backstage to welcome a real princess in a silk kimono.
Mrs. McDonald. Susan Benson, who designed the production.
And this has come straight. You're in the middle of it, are you, in fact?
Well, not exactly. We've been playing the gondoliers, and we stuck this together rather quickly. We came to see. Well, if Mr. Mervish invites us, he'd very much bring it. Yes. Marie Baron, or Yum Yum.
And you've been doing this for a couple of years. Yes. And presumably, if you go from one to the other, it'll be quite easy.
Yes.
On a good night.
Yes. Back home in Stratford, Big Ben and the Houses of Parliament will provide the setting for Act Two of Iolanthe.
Down to the mirrors, the windows. Incredible.
Susan, who did that piece?
Roy decorating in props and Neil actually working it out.
It's really marvelous. We must light it very carefully so that all that magic is really appreciated. It's, so detailed. And what happens to the wood between the fence and the front?
That'll get floor colored, right? Eventually. I mean, there's still quite a lot
to work to do on it. Yeah.
To do on it yet. Looks great.
Wonderful. Absolutely.
Our productions use a special stage which takes a full hour and a half to assemble or strike. It's adapted from the old raked opera stages of Europe, and actually slopes upwards so that singers and performers near the back can still be clearly seen and heard. Mind you, it's a little more work dancing uphill.
I love thee, we must
slip down here. Who's with you? Is it Janet? And you're on this side of her, aren't you? And if she says you're an Arcadian shepherd, and then if you went, boom, and came right down here, so you only have to get that far to say part of the line, you know.
Yeah.
It's just I want to provide her with the information moving in a large way, so if you could react immediately. Just to, let's do that little thing. Arcadian shepherd. Where is everybody on Arcadian shepherd?
Oh,
yes, go ahead.
And what is he?
He's an Arcadian shepherd.
Oh.
And he loves Phyllis, a ward in Chancery.
A mere shepherd? And he's half a fairy.
He's a fairy down to the waist, but his legs are immortal.
Dear me.
I have no reason to suppose that I am more normal than others. But I must admit, I would love to see a person who is a fairy down to the waist, but whose legs are mortal. Nothing easier, for here he comes.
Good morrow, good mother. Good mother, good morrow. By some means or other, pray banish your sorrow. With joy be untelling, my bosom is swelling, so join in a measure expressive of pleasure, for I'm to be married today, today. Yes, I'm to be married today.
Yes, done. That was dead on, didn't you feel it?
Mm-hmm.
You know, that was excellent.
Yeah.
It was so good, I think we'll do it again. All right? It had a lovely conviction to it, just right. And remember, sitting around a table here, it's the conviction that it's purely vocal. There's no visual. So if you can convey it vocally, we're in.
Sure.
Yeah?
Okay.
Bert, whenever you're ready.
Good morrow, good mother. Good mother, good morrow. By some means or other, pray banish your sorrow. With joy be untelling, my bosom is swelling, so join in a measure expressive of pleasure, for I'm to be married today, today. Yes, I'm to be married today.
Yes, he's to be married today, today. Yes, he's to be married today.
Both Gilbert and Sullivan were fascinated by the naughty characters of the British music halls, and we've kept that spirit alive in our costumes, like the one Marie Baron wears for her role as Phyllis.
It's great.
Proud to present the difference.
Now it's got to go to.
You see, what worries me is, well, let's hold that and look at him in the mirror and see how much we see of him. We don't see a bloody thing, do we?
Don't see a bloody thing.
No. Can you cut out the swear?
If it's through threads and there's a little gadget that you can grab hold of.
Now, look, pull on that. There.
Everybody ready? Here it comes.
Here it comes.
I want to see it, too.
These are the men's fairy wings. The ladies are slightly different because the ladies get to put them on off stage, but the men have to grow them on stage. So they have to actually grow right out of their coats. Well, the wings are done with piano wire, so that they're flexible and they bounce back to the proper position. Then there's a little barrel fastener on here, fastens to the bone. There's a channel down in the coat into which the wings slide. That's connected by this cord which runs through the inside collar and out here so that the actor can grab the string and pull.
It must be very tricky to get them in there.
It is. The folding process is important because otherwise they jam inside. Has been known to fail.
Oh, I don't believe that.
We start every rehearsal day with a dance warm-up. Company members are trained actors or singers, but the productions emphasize not only movement but dancing. So we look for people who are happy in motion, and we end up with tenors and basses, sopranos and mezzos who can actually dance.
Pick it up. Peace and quiet we have here. Okay.
Spurn not the nobly born. I spent a sleepless night last night. That's why I'm unshaven. My contacts are bothering me, so I'm wearing glasses. But in a vision, some words came to me for the second verse. And I thought maybe I'd share them because it's something to do with, I think, dancing was going on in my head.
Oh, I can't understand why.
Yeah.
Okay.
I wish it would go on in my legs. Just from the intro, please, yeah.
Spurn not the nobly born with love affected.
Auditions are taken very seriously by our panel of judges. Bert Carrier, our musical director, Kelly Robinson, assistant choreographer, myself, and Anne Wooten, the assistant director. Stratford always has had a tradition of casting the understudy roles from the ranks of the chorus.
When virtuous love is sought, thy power is not, nor dating from the flood, blue blood, of blue blood. The pain of dream ballet rehearsals, which to my tight hamstrings can cause reversals. Voices, though pure and fair, can't do a tour en l'air. I used to think that Kelly and I were pals. Turn out of what avail.
Well, Richard, what am I to say? We'll make you the ballet master.
The word prestige is French, okay?
John Hirsch is Stratford's artistic director and he unexpectedly drops in to watch one of our rehearsals.
They've started.
Yeah,
they've started. Kelly takes them every morning over there.
Oh, it's Stephen Godfrey. Oh. I can help you with that spacing. Folks, just before we take a break, would you show Mr. Hirsch our lapse of style?
Oh.
One, two, and yaw.
Gilbert and Sullivan is a wonderful medium for poking fun at politics. And the Canadian political scene is certainly no exception.
So
keep the thumb up.
It doesn't, right?
If I go like this, you're holding something. If I go like this, maybe you're not.
No. The palm looks flatter.
The palm looks flatter. So it's just a matter of practicing that.
You just hold it in there.
Same.
Paul Massel plays Streffen, mortal from the waist down. Here he's perfecting some fairy magic he can perform from the waist up.
Fly, cross, 2, 3, 1, heel and step. Stay one, back to touch, step 2, 3.
Our production of The Gondoliers is now into preview performances. Kelly keeps the company on their toes. This is where the little flaws are polished away and new cast members catch on and catch up. It's the sixth preview. We're still experimenting. My second act needs somehow to go one notch higher. That usually means another production number. Now, the perfect place would be after the trio, but that means a new orchestration from Bert and new choreography for the chorus. With only 2 days left before opening night, and with two other shows in performance, is our cast ready to try?
Just the gentleman, please. Okay, why don't we just clean up a little bit our first breaks? After da-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum, the breaks at the end of that. We did it so fast this morning that we're not all quite together. It's going to be fun, I can tell, I have to have a sense.
First break, we did that 3 times.
Yeah.
And it's down, shuffle, ball, change, down, shuffle, ball, change. Down, shuffle, ball, change, down, shuffle, ball, change. Faster and da 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 da
and down is on the beat. Yeah, da 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 da. Well, actually, that is the best. It's the most tap dance. It's the most Ruby Keeler.
Yeah.
It really is. When the arms are all out, you look like you're doing thousands of taps there. Dougie was doing the opposite to everybody, so you better tell me whether it is. It's there.
Yes.
The arm up on the supporting foot. Okay?
Oh, Dougie, I was with you.
The arm?
The arm is
the supporting foot is the one that's down. Da 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 da. Yeah, da 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 da. Okay?
So it's
up on the supporting foot. Da 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 da. Close. Yeah, that it was. Let's try it. Five, six, seven, eight. 1, 2, 3, 4. 6, 7, 8. Dun, 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 dun. Let's take a break and come back, okay? We'll figure out what connects those two things.
It's opening night, and this is how it went.
I'll take heart and make her stop.
Of the legal mind are equal to the emergency. Oh, yes, it's really quite simple. The introduction of a single word will do it. Let it stand that every fairy shall die who don't marry a mortal. And there you have it. Out of your difficulty at once.
We like your humor.
May I?
Very well, Private Willis.
Ma'am?
To save my life, it is necessary that I marry immediately. How would you like to become a fairy guardsman?
Well, ma'am, I don't think much of the pretty soldier who wouldn't inconvenience himself to save a female in distress.
You are a brave fellow. you are a fairy from this moment. Oh.
From persons of intelligence, I don't see what use we are down here, do you, Tallulah?
None whatever.
Good! Then away we go to Fairyland!
As Iolanthe nears its finale, what we've all worked for seems to be there. The acting, the singing, the laughter, the music, and the magic.
Soon as we may, up and away, we'll commence our journey. Very happy are we, as you can see.
Academy Award-winning producer John Zaritsky looks at four courageous people battling a devastating enemy, severe arthritis. CBC Television presents I'll Get There Somehow, Sunday. Pornography is the issue before Judge Humphreys when a filmmaker goes on trial, next on CBC Television.